Hear the song of a fool. How the fool broke a rule. Is he really a fool?
Yes, fools rush in where angels fear to tread.
Meds, tampons, hygienic protection. For you, every time.
Hey, look at this.
What is it?
An old lamp, I think.
3,000 years in that. How dull. You know the deal? Three wishes and all that?
Three, huh? All right. I want a packet of Tim Tams that never runs out.
You have two wishes left.
Then we'll have two more of those.
Arnott's Tim Tam. What more could you want?
I train about 30 hours a week. It's pretty hard. Sometimes it's sucky because, you want to play with your friends but you can't. Just the thought you could go to the Olympics helps. If I tried really, really, really hard, I might make it. If it's in Sydney, then, all your family and friends could come and watch and be really great.
When you're standing up behind the blocks and the starter's about to pull the trigger and you can't control your knees because they're shaking too much, it's the experience of the Olympic Games. If Australia got behind this bid with Sydney for 2000, put as much effort as I did back in 1968, they'd know just what the Olympic Games is about. And I must say that my memories are fantastic.
Sydney's changed so much since I came here, but I never tire of it. It's my home. You wouldn't believe some of the things I've seen. So many changes, but mostly for the better. Sydney's grown up. If I could see in the year 2000, the Olympics in my Sydney, I'd have seen it all.
You paint the earth all golden brown. You taste of cooling fire and light. You wear the sun like a fiery crown. You shine, you glow, you gild the night. Your gleaming smile is dark and warm. Your kiss is soft as silk and flame. You're the night and of the dawn. You always change but stay the same. Dear Maria, drink it in.
Do you have a pen and paper?
No.
Come on, Lou.
John, the stuff in my room. My washing?
Yeah, I've done it. It's my turn.
As you can see, with Double Action Dry, the toughest stains will come out in the wash.
Oh, great day with the kids. I do a lot of laundry myself now.
Judy's so busy working.
Do you? You never did when we were married.
I can never get my clothes as clean as yours. How do you do it? Do you pre-soak or what?
No, I just use this.
Drive's two different enzymes give it the power to shift stains.
Well, it sure works. Look at this shirt. Hang on a sec. Whose shirt is this?
Charlotte.
With Double Action Drive, the toughest stains will come out in the wash.
Hey, Robbo, coming down the pub for a cold one?
Nah, mate, no. Reckon I'll just go straight home tonight.
Yeah, his girlfriend moved in on the weekend. Oh, Robbo.
Hi.
G'day. I'll just get out of my work here.
How was your day?
Fine. Good, yeah. How's yours?
All good.
Caro, have you seen the overalls?
Yeah, here they are. Forgot to put them in the machine last night.
Great. Thanks. Shouldn't have.
As you can see, with Double Action Drive, the toughest stains will come out in the wash.
Look, have you got PMT or something?
No, I'm angry. If I had PMT, I'd do something about it. I'd take starflower oil.
There's no better way than nature's way.
I had nothing to do on this hot afternoon but to settle and write you a line. Though I ain't begging or losing my head, I sure do want you to know that you wear it well. There ain't a lady in the land so
younger than today. I never needed anybody's help in any way. Help me if you can, I'm feeling
down. We're on the way to my brother's wedding. I've got the bride.
And I do appreciate you.
Time for a cuppa. Oh, I've got the sugar.
Can I have one of yours?
I take two.
Oh, got one?
No.
I'll give you one of my fish.
The big one. Oh, sweet.
Real Australians love real sugar.
Sugar.
Well, sweetheart, before you take your boots off, could you pop next door and borrow a cup of sugar?
Sugar. Righto.
Thanks.
Real Australians love real sugar.
Wow! Look at this!
Happy anniversary, darling.
Okay. Okay. Just don't move.
Okay, it says we've got to stare into each other's eyes for 20 minutes.
20 minutes? Why?
to get to the eternal space.
What the bloody hell's the eternal space?
I don't know. We haven't got there yet.
All right, then. Give it a go. Sorry.
Oh. Okay. And now it's on to circular breathing. You breathe in through your nose and out through your penis. And I breathe in through my vagina. And out. It's okay. It says here, everyone giggles at first.
So, what do we do next?
Apparently, we get into a state of orgasm that lasts for 8 hours. But let's not skip ahead. What's the matter, Mick?
Well, I just need to,
Be quick. Oh, and...
Don't miss anything up in there. We need it in chapter two.
How many bloody chapters are there? Does she think I'm 17 again?
...86% of women over the age of 50 do not see themselves in ads and don't think that brands care about them. Nobody's actually created an overarching narrative for us. Nobody has defined this generation. We're the first women ever in the history of the world that are going to live twice as long as our original biological purpose. And we're also the first generation of women that came into the workforce en masse. So many women are losing their jobs in their late 40s, early 50s. It is an epidemic. I had a remarkable 36-year career in advertising, incredibly successful, but found myself in my mid-50s...
You have 2 wishes left.
...unemployable and invisible to my industry. Back in 2015, figures came out that only 3% of the world's creative directors were female. Now, that's a shocking figure. But what's really shocking about it is ultimately, these are the people who decide what we see in ads. So the start of the project was actually me going out and finding who were the women over 50 that were creating ads and what was their experience. I put a call out on Twitter to find out if there were actually any women creating the ads in London. And I got 8 names. So I listened to these women and their stories, and they weren't really about advertising. And what was coming through was this theme of invisibility. Currently on the website, we focused on 20 women, all of whom have got really incredible stories and have done amazing things. The shocking thing about that is if you look on that website, is half of them are not making a living. Now, when people go and look at that and see that, they are absolutely flabbergasted and horrified. We're working with brands and sponsors to create this new narrative with content and film by us, for us, about us, to tell the world who we are and exactly what we're capable of. We're already starting to get women noticed, we're already starting to get women employed, and that is the first stage. I've been absolutely blown away by the response to the Uninvisibility Project. We've been contacted from women from all over the world. And I joke that we're not building an audience, but we're recruiting an army.